Welcome to the Mischief. I'm Valen, and this is a very peaceful Sky Factory 2.5. Today we're going to learn how to kill squids. No, we already did this. So we're just going to kind of catch up with where we were last time and do a little bit of some comments. You guys came up with some pretty good stuff there. So compacting drawer fix. Let's go examine that first, shall we? So first and foremost, I'm a derp, as most of you already know. I need to put a filter in the node, or else it's just going to pull all the blocks out. Well, not in that one per se, but in the next one that I would have down, this one here, I would have to put a filter in here saying it needs to be double compressed that comes out. Otherwise, it's just going to pull it straight out. So let's make a quick filter, and we'll get that set. Oh, advanced. Oh, those are all advanced ones. I just want a normal filter. Can I get? Yes, please. Thank you. Now I just need some cobble. Grab a little bit of that. And if we can get this working, wait. Here we go. One of those. And the reason I need one of those is to put it in the filter. So right click, put that in there, and now it will filter out only those, or I can't remember, or if it will cancel out those. I can't remember which one, but I guess I'll find out. So if I do that, and I actually don't have any. There we go. This should work. Let's just put that in there, and that'll go in. And oh, it worked. Excellent. Okay, so that did work. Then it's just a matter of speed upgrades for the transfer nodes in order to get them in there. And as fast as they can go through the transfer nodes, they should be compacted. Now, from what I understand, I was also informed that they only go up so high. I can only compact them with compacting drawers. Oh, Lego sheep, you are weird. So many levels before it'll actually stop and not compacting anymore. Which makes sense. I can understand that. So I will get to that shortly. And in the meantime, let's get some rewards out for those that came up with an idea or the fix for that. And that would be Sable Drake and Glarvol. So let's get them on the board. Here we go. Sable Drake. See if I can actually edit the sign here. And then we'll do the usual Mischief emoticon. And then we've got Glarvol. Good old Glarvol. Whoa. If I can actually hold still long enough. There we go. Almost there, Glarvol. Almost there. And I did switch out the big empty space that I had that was wood. Put in some of these factory blocks here. I was originally going to try and make them into slabs because when you look down on the texture, they've got like this indentation, which is kind of cool for like an avatar to stand on. But they didn't really cut that way. They only cut vertically. They wouldn't cut horizontally. So I couldn't do the slabs. So I just decided I'd turn it into one big support structure for the moment. And I'll plan on adding more to that as we go. So good job, guys, on helping me out with the simplicity that was my derp on that one. I should have known that one. I don't know why I didn't think of it. It's kind of obvious. But because it was just taking the cobblestone straight through. It was because it didn't have enough time to gain 9 at a time in order to compact them. It was just filtering them straight out. So next on the list, we have making a villager. Now, there are a lot of ways of making a villager, and you guys came up with a lot more creative ways than I could possibly come up with in one. The one that I wanted to do actually isn't in this mod pack. I think it involves Biomes of Plenty or Botania in 110. I can't remember. But either way, it's not in the mod pack, so I'm not going to do that. Maybe I'll do that on some other series. But the suggestions we came up with are the de-zombification syringe is one of them. Right here, and that is made with an empty syringe and a golden apple, which, you know, empty syringe isn't too bad, just some plastic sheets, rubber bar, and an iron ingot. So, you know, then you just find a zombie villager, syringe him, and you've got a villager, which is really good. I like that. That's really good. I just have to kind of sit over there in the zombie farm, syringe one, and then, you know, lasso him first, then take him to a safe spot, syringe him, and he'll follow me around and stuff while he's a zombie villager, so it's not a big deal. But then another suggestion was to cure a zombie villager using the traditional vanilla Minecraft method of a weakness potion and a golden apple. I was aware of this. I just forgot. It's been a very long time since I've ever even wanted to do that. But it does work, and that is a very good method of doing it. And if I couldn't make a weakness potion, if I have a mob spawner, which I do here, eventually a witch will spawn in there. And I could feasibly grab the witch and then grab some zombie villagers that spawn in there and try and get it so that the witch splashes a weakness potion and gets us both. Or just so it sets up so that the zombie's between us. And then she could do the weakness potion. And then I just give them the golden apple, which would be great. But that is another way of doing it. And then, of course, probably one of my most loved ones would be the spirit dimension, which, you know, we've got our spirit cow here. You go into the spirit dimension via witchery, which is a ways off. That's not an easy thing to really get into. And it will spawn an entire vanilla world, complete with villages and so on. So therefore, that would be really good to just go around and grab some villagers. And then, of course, there's the last one, which is the one that I think I'm probably going to go with because it just sounds interesting. And that is the last Millennium dimension, which has one non-tradable villager inside. I can nab him. I can make him into a mob spawner, and then I could spawn myself more of him via that method. And I figured, you know what? Why not a dimension? Let's do the dimension of the last dimension there. And there was a lot of people that suggested all these things. I'm not going to say who suggested which one. I'm just going to go around, and we're going to cover all the people that gave the suggestions. Once again, we had Sable Drake. The king of recommendations, we have Ravin Singh, or the current king at the very least. TubeFan 90,000. And brand new, we have Neil King. And new, we also have Joltsan, which of course had to kind of make me extend it out a little bit. Well, I'll work on kind of straightening that up in a bit, but that worked pretty good. And last but not least, we have, of course, Kixinos, which actually has a little bit more going on than just this one. Kixinos, let's see if I can actually get two in there. There we go. Yeah, that looks centered. Gets two, because Kixino did that suggestion for making a villager. And also came up with a wonderful idea to replace wireless activation, and that is the Ender IO mod. And not just the mod itself, but the block that it's all based around. Let me show you this. Actually, I want to make this. So I think it's actually just called Ender IO. Yeah, hold shift. I've never used it before. And it's the block that the entire mod was created around. Allow remote access to nearby blocks. And that means all the nearby blocks in like a 7x7x7 area or a 7-block cube. Now with that, let's see if we can make it. It doesn't look too bad. How much of this am I missing? Oh, I'm just missing the Eye of Ender. That's not bad at all. There we go. And then craft this, Ender IO. Used with travel anchors or the staff of travel. Well, let's give it a go, shall we? So a 7-block area. Let's, I'm going to just dig up this one here. Let me grab this, because I'm gonna move these over. Now that this, actually makes a little bit more sense coming down from these other spot. And I can actually put this right behind it. I think that makes sense. There we go. Ooh, it's like looking at me. That's kind of cool. That's really slick. I like that. So let me grab my staff of traveling. Ooh. So if I hit shift and that didn't work. Oh boy, that just teleported me through things. That kind of scared the heck out of me. So what happens if I, there we go. So if I put this in here, and it's private, protected, public, it doesn't really matter. We're gonna call this the remote access and see what happens, because I've never used one of these before. And I obviously, when I hold this wand, it currently has all this stuff. So what if I use, if I right click, all right, that's really creepy. Okay, so I can rotate things, and wow, this is pretty neat. So what if I want to access? Oh, I just right-click on it, and it allows me to access it. That's amazing. And then I can grab something out. I put back in. Oh my gosh, that's pretty neat. That's pretty neat. So the only question I have is, okay, it remembers the way that it was last time. So if I right-click over here, it does take a second for it to, like, fade in and out. So what if I can access... Oh, yeah, that does take a few seconds for me to do it, but now I can access this. That's sweet. All right, so now I could even access this. I could access my achievements. I could access the anvil. Oh, wow. So if it's within 7 blocks, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I might even be able to access the enchanter. That's pretty neat. That's really good. And this wand becomes so much more useful. Okay. Wow. All right. Yeah, I think... Definitely learned something good today. That was awesome. Thanks, Kixinos. I really appreciate that. So now that we've kind of messed around a little bit here, I figured we could try and get into the whole villager thing there. So what I had in mind was making the last millennium. So if I look up this, just typing in millennium, portal to the last millennium. Recipe for this is a little bit more complex than one might think. It varies from mod pack to mod pack. But in this case, I mean, I'd have to make a clock, which is really, really easy. So there we go, a clock. Then we've got to make burnt quartz, which I need blocks of quartz. And I think I have quartz in here. Yes, in fact, I've got a couple blocks, and heck, I've got a bunch more. So let's just clear this out and make... a little bit more. 1, 2, and grab the other two blocks, and I can cook these up in why not, in my flour machine. Let's use the blue one because it's prettier, and I'll take the stone out, put the stone in. There we go. Now millennium, it's the dyes that I think are going to be difficult, because the carved eminence stone requires regular stone plus a couple dyes. Now, I could start up a Tanya and work on that, but that, I feel, will drag things out a little bit further than I had intended on doing. I do have ender pearls, of course, but I was thinking dyes, regular dyes. Best way to get that? With Technicolor Essence. Well, how do you get Technicolor Essence? Well, my friends, by making dye seeds, and making dye seeds requires a bunch of dyes plus Accio Essence and Minicio seeds. So let's make some Minicio seeds. Oh, look, I've got some already set up. It's like a baking program where I've got some of this stuff already organized and set for you guys so that you don't have to necessarily watch all the time me crafting everything. But I am going to need some Accio Essence, and I do have a bit of that. And if I do need more, I've got some Zivicchio here I could break down, or some Crucio, which I think can... Oops. I didn't want to type that. I wanted to... See, the recipe for this was, Accio. So I could break this down into a lower tier if I need to. So if I go with that, I can't remember what it was. Let's type in the Millennium again. Come on, double L. There we go. Millennium, and then this, and then this, and this, and that. There we go. So I've got a bunch of bone meal already in my inventory. I've got Minicio seeds already in the system, so I just need Accio Essence, and it's on the cardinal side. So let's get some seeds here. If I don't have enough seeds, well, yeah, there's the seeds. Okay, and then we've got the bone meal. I believe it just needs to be any color dye, so bone meal or, hey, ink might even work in this case. I can also add in some of those, this Accio Essence, and therefore, yep, there we go, that's one. So if I do this enough times, I can make a bunch of these, but yeah, I'm gonna need a bit more. So let me get a little bit more essence. In fact, I'm gonna grab one of the Zivicchio Essence, and I think I can just turn this into 4 Imperio, and then the Imperio can be turned into Crucio, and then the Crucio can be turned into Accio, which is perfect. I need a bunch of that, so that's what I'm going to take. 1 stack of Accio. That's awesome. All right, so then I could do this, and I will have a lot of dye seeds, which is perfect, because I just wanted a bunch of dye seeds. Now, if I make like this, hey, look at that. Perfect. That's one, two. Oh, that's. I need a lot of seeds. Man, seeds are so expensive. Yeah, I need to get that thing up and running. Sorry about the little frame rate loss there. So, hey, look, I already have Technicolor. Oh, it's so loud. Wow. Why you do that? That's so rude. Oh my gosh. All right, what I could do is then go down in here. I thought I had those seeds already planted somewhere. Where did I plant the Technicolor seeds? You know, it probably harvested it and just kind of left it there. That's kind of disappointing. So what do we have here? Iron seeds. What is this way? It is the opposite of the blue. So it's the dark blue is the one that's closest. So let's do that. And then we're going to take out... Heck, I'm going to take out the potato farm for now. And we're going to put that in there. And we're going to see about getting Technicolor essence. That should get me more... That's essence. Why am I planting the essence? I don't know. Let's put the potatoes back in there. That was a really poor idea. Take these, put them in there. All right. I'm kind of derping at the moment here. Sorry about that. I should have taken the Technicolor seeds that we have in here. Let's seed. Dye seeds. That's what I was talking about. And planting those in here so that I can actually get more of the Technicolor essence in a simpler fashion than just using them to, you know, duplicate things. Actually, I think recipe for this is only from seeds, isn't it? Ooh, yeah. So what do I get from one of these seeds that grows? I'm curious now. I'm gonna go out to our little farm out here because this is actually gonna be really darn quick if I remember properly. And I'll just kind of break this, plant that, and I can, do I have a watering can? I think that the watering can works. I haven't actually tried it, to be honest, but I figure if I try this with a, hey, look at that. Oh, and it looks like I do get the essence from it. So if I just make more of these seeds, I shouldn't have turned them into essence. I should have just planted them and then just watering canned it really quick. And then that would have gotten me exactly what I wanted. Maybe. Oh, look, it's rotating colors. That's actually really cool. All right, let's break it and see what I get. Oh, I got a Technicolor essence from that. Oh, I wasted so many of those seeds. Oh my gosh. Well, in the meantime, I'm going to plant you there. And then I'm going to see about making some more because I should have enough to actually make a bit more, I think. Let's see here. We've got some medicinal essence. Wow. That's enough. Thank you. We're done with those guys. We're so done with those guys. Oh man, that's enough. Okay, and these need to go elsewhere. I think I'm gonna need to take care of this. Hey, I've got a dye seed in here. Perfect. Grab some more of these, and I think that's a good start for the moment. Actually, I'm gonna go plant this dye seed because by the time I get back, it should already be done. But this is just so I can make a couple dyes. It's kind of ridiculous, but there we go. And that's I just saw the other one just tick up. It's growing already. That's going to be good once I get that up and running, if I ever get around to it. I'm so overburdened with so many things that I need to complete. Speaking of, there is a lot of stuff coming up. There is Sky Factory 3.0. I think it's actually just been released. I could be mistaken on that one. So let me know what your guys' thoughts are on starting up a new series. I know that I'm not endgame on this one yet. And I could continue on this one for a while. If you want to see me continue on with this, let me know. If you want to see me switch out, start over, brand new on a Sky Factory 3.0 series, I would like to know. So let's do this. And I don't think I'm going to have enough to get 64 of the seeds, but that's okay. I can get a large amount. Regular seeds. There we go. Grab this, put that over there, and voila. Then I can grab this and kind of do that a bit and that a bit and this a bit. I know it's kind of getting a bit weird here. I'm almost done with it. There we go. And one more. Cool. Yeah, I've got 7 left, so we're just going to leave those in there. And that gives me 51 Minicio seeds. And then with a bit of Accio essence. I did not just type that. Sorry, folks. Essence. All right. Yeah, I've got one Technicolor Essence. I might as well grab it. But I could grab some... You know, I'm just going to grab another one of the Zavikio because I've got it already. Might as well. And I can just do this, this, and that. Done. Now, clearing this out, if I take the Accio Essence and split this here, put the Manicio seeds in the middle, get myself some more bone meal, which we don't have that much bone meal, I guess. Take it back. We've got a lot of bone meal. And I've got more on the farms over there. So I'm just going to do that at the moment. 16 dye seeds. That is much, much improved. And I realize I should put them over there. But for the moment, because this is the only one that has a current farm running. Let's see. I want... So that's bright blue here. It's dark blue on the other side. So I want dark blue here. There. And we're going to put these... I'm doing it again with the Technicolor Essence. What am I doing? That's really annoying. So we're going to do that and then toss the carrots out and be done with that. There we go. That should hopefully start replacing things as they grow. In the meantime, I could probably take one, two, so that I have an even four on this four plant plot. And then I can just break these and get what I need for the immediate moment here. One, two, and then I break these. I should be using a hoe. I realize that now. I should be using the one of the hoes that I have, at least the Crucio hoe. So I, but no, that's only good for the Manicio. My bad. But if I use that watering can, which I have right here. I didn't even look at it. How much do I have? I have 7 Technicolor Essence. I think that's enough to get me 2 dyes, but I just want to be extra sure, so I'm going to get 1 harvest of these guys, and then that should be enough for me to get enough to make... Because I think one harvest makes... or one crafting of those Millennium Stones makes enough for 4, so therefore I can make that portal block as expected. This is taking longer than I thought it would for this. Come on, you should be growing. I need to get more growth pulsers underneath these guys. All right, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I might as well replant these 4 because they look really cool when they're ripe or ready to be harvested. And I don't know if many of you have ever been to the last Millennium. It's supposed to, or at least it is in the future, and in many mod packs, not necessarily this one, a method for you to start a base in the void. Well, hey, in Sky Factory 2.5, we're in the void already, so it's not really necessary, but it allows you access to doing so, and it's pretty cool. It's usually very low cost to enter into, but in this version, it's a little bit more because I'm typing it wrong and I'm in the wrong menu. So let me get over here. But it is really cool. It's based on Chrono Trigger, the video game, if you're not familiar with it. And I'm spelling it wrong still. Millennium, not Millennium. There we go. One of these. So there, purple dye. How do I make purple dye? Okay. 1 crafting of purple dye. Done. Now I need, I think it's the magenta. Magenta. All right. And 1 crafting of that. That's more than enough. That's more than enough because I've got those now. So let's... Why is it doing magenta on both? That's really awkward. All right. There we go. Carved Eminence Stone. Perfect. I can clear that out. Recipe for this is not ready yet because I've got to get my quartz. There we go. Now... Oh, and it lost the... Let's see if I can actually do this proper Millennium Stone here. And there we go. Portal to the last Millennium. Where shall I place it? Oh, well, I've got my portals over here, so I might as well put it over here with it. Let's put it right there. Ooh, cool stuff. All right. So let's kind of get ready for this. I'm going to need some torches. Grab the torches and... In we go. I think it's more than just standing on it. I think I actually have to like shift click it or something. Well, unless I've got a torch in my hand. Or is it just, is it working? I don't know. There's a lot of purple particles right now. So let's shift right click with an empty hand. There we go. And now our villager buddy, the last villager. Oh, how you doing? And he has a little cauldron over here. There's no treasure chests or anything like that. There is, you know, a block of burnt quartz and just this little, it's very peaceful here. Everything's black. Everything's black. Let's light it up a little bit because this is very sad, actually. put a few torches around in the corners at least. I don't know that mobs will spawn. They probably will. These might all be half blocks for all I know. But just for a little bit of eminence sake, that there you go. This is the entire dimension right here. Not too much to it. And if you wanted to get back, you just, you know, shift right click on this, and this guy just kind of hangs around, so I can just grab this guy now and we can turn him back into, or we can respawn him and then put him back there, potentially, maybe. I don't know, we'll see how it goes. But I could spawn multiples of those and then I can make that attraction obelisk that I've been trying to make here, which I think it's gonna work out pretty good. Now can I make a spawner? Spawner. Stabilized mob spawner. I'm going to need a powered spawner. There we go. Ooh, this is going to be interesting. I need some kind of head. That's not going to be a problem. Let's see if I have any already in the system. Yup, I sure do. Let's grab a zombie head, and then we'll go back to the spawner. Powered spawner. Not an Enderman one, just an empty one. There we go. So I need electrical steel, vibrant crystal, Z logic controller. How much am I missing? All right, vibrant crystal. Need to make one of those. Oh, vibrant alloy. I am one short. So the recipe for that is two vibrant alloys together makes two ingots. I still love that. All right, enderpearl and an energetic alloy. All right, let me grab an enderpearl. One of those. No, one of those. And alloy. One of those. That's all I need. I just want one. So I'm not going to really mess around with that too much. Let's see here. I need the, not the sag mill, the alloy. Boop, boop. And that should do it. Alloys only. That should give me the one ingot I need so that I can make this spawner that I'm looking to do. There we go. Oh, give it back. Give it. And then I need to break it down into bits. Boom. And I've got enough to make another crafting of stuff as well because I've got eight remaining after this, which is going to be good. There we go. Boop. And I now have another vibrant crystal. Heck, I'll make another vibrant crystal. Why not? Now I've got an extra one as well. So, spawner. Once again. Powered spawner. Empty. Z-Logic controller. So I need solarium, silicon, redstone, and a zombie head, which I just used up. Crud. Let's go get a zombie head. I think I've got some potential zombie heads down here. Oh, I never used up that one zombie head. That's weird. Let me put the other one back. And some carrots away. And some of these away. And that away. I don't need any of that stuff. Put those away in that. Hey, look at this. Inventory management. Just clicking on it and it's gone. Now, I've got this. I'll need the solarium and the silicon. So let's see how fortunate or unfortunate I am. Oh, excellent. I've got plenty of solarium. So silicon. I've got plenty of silicon. And I've got a zombie head. I need redstone. And yes, I do have that, and I think it might already have an axe in it, or shears, or whatever it might need. Let's see here. Is it, that's a soul binder, slice and splice? I think it's in here. This, and that. Now that will take a little bit of time because this doesn't have any kind of capacitor in it, but it, actually it's going just fast enough. It is perfectly fine. I don't need to upgrade this thing because it's not really worthwhile. I mean, I suppose I could, but there we go. Z-Logic controller. Now I've got all I need to make that spawner, minus the villager. So let's do spawner. And here we go. Powered spawner. No, not the Enderman one. Empty one. All right. So there's that. Powered spawner combined with a broken spawner in an anvil. Oh. I'm going to need a broken spawner. I don't have a broken spawner. Where do I get a broken spawner? Don't I have a spawner already, though? I thought that I was spawning stuff before. That's a slice and splice, pulverizer, iron chest, soul binder. This allows me to put dudes into a broken spawner. I don't think I have a broken spawner. Oh my gosh, where can I get one? I'm not sure. Well, just the same, I now have a powered spawner. So that could be useful. Now I just need to combine it with that, and I can put the villager into a soul vial and then go from there. So in the meantime, I'm going to set it right here. And it's going to charge up, but it's not going to spawn anything because it's currently... there we go. Never active at the moment anyway. But there's nothing in it for it to spawn. And I can go grab that last Millennium Villager anytime I want. But in the meantime, I think I'm going to leave it to you guys to come up with a potential... Oh, gosh, I forgot that I'm a freaking Power Ranger. So you guys with a Mr. Kool-Aid face on my chest. If you could come up with a way for me to find a broken spawner. I think there might be one. I might be able to find like blaze spawners in the Nether. I don't know if those have been turned off or not. It'd be worth checking out. There may be other dimensions I could go to, like the Deep Dark. Ooh, that could be really cool. I mean, I just need to do a lot of compressed cobblestone so I can get there, which would be crafting. Oh boy, I'm gonna have to get those cobblestone crafting away. But anyway, that's a couple thoughts that I've had. Do you guys have some other suggestions on how I can find some spawners, break them, and use those for making a powered spawner? Please let me know in the comments. And also, let me know what you think about possibly switching it up to Sky Factory 3.0. And I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. If so, please give a like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to share the mischief with others if you think they'll enjoy this content. Until next time, folks, I'll see ya.